I would like to talk about the situation in Palestine, in Gaza Strip and West Bank. And I would like to talk about the first of Gaza. As you may know, that Israeli occupation continues to impose its blockade on Gaza Strip and to target Palestinian civilians by assassination. Its airstrike and persisting with its war of aggression of 3 years ago on Gaza, which resulted in massive destruction of homes, schools, hospitals, and mosques, and the thousands of martyrs. And I would like to show some of the photos to clarify the size of destruction of homes and this in Gaza Strip. You can see how the destruction of homes. You see. I think these sums of photos clarify the crimes of Israeli occupation against the civilians in Palestine. You can see the massive destruction here. I have a lot of photos. I suggest we can make as we can show all of these photos. Okay, this war, I would like to speak about the consequences of this war. In total, 1,400 Palestinians were killed in this war. 83% of the dead. Majority of them were civilians, the so-called protected persons of international humanitarian law. A further 5,300 were injured. The single most brutal event in the history of the occupation was characterized by systematic violations of international law. The consequences of impunity are evident in the fact that the entire Gaza Strip continues to be subject to an illegal closure. For many years, 2 million people have been collectively punished and cut from the outside world. Impunity and the international community failure to prevent this ongoing crime has resulted in the distinct possibility that the closure will become institutionalized. We live in Gaza Strip, that there is no enough water, electricity, fuel, and medicine. It is really genocide. It is not recorded before in the history of humanity. I want to speak also about the situation, political situation in general. Of course, Oslo peace process has failed. The primary cause for the failure of the peace process, the collapse of dozens of opportunities. The core issue here is that the Israeli government refuses to commit to term of reference for negotiation that are based on international law and United Nations resolutions. And that It frantically continues to intensify building of settlements on the territories of the state of Palestine. Settlements activities embody the core of the policy of colonial military occupation of the land of Palestinian people. The occupation is racing against the time to redraw the borders on our land according to what it wants and to impose a fait accompli on the ground that changes the realities. Palestinians are asking for international recognition of their state on the 1967 borders, including East Jerusalem, as stipulated in international resolution. They also seek admission to the United Nations as a full member. The establishment of Palestinian state was a promise made to the Palestinian people by international community, whose fulfillment that is long overdue. The right of the Palestinian people to an independent sovereign state has awaited implementation for 64 years. It is a debt owed by the international community to the Palestinian people. While UN admission and recognition will not physically remove Israel forces from occupied territories, Palestinians believe that this is a crucial step that will contribute to the inevitable end of occupation and the realization of Palestinian rights. It will realign the political process and discourse with the international law. International recognition and UN membership bring Palestinian closer to freedom by consecrating the two-state solution. They strengthen the possibility of reaching a just and lasting peace based on international Andrews term of reference for resolving the conflict. The right to self-determination of Palestinian people, like that of all peoples, is an inalienable right that is not for negotiation. The establishment of sovereign and viable Palestinian is a debt owed by the international community to the Palestinian people. This is long overdue.
Hear, hear. Long overdue.
This right has awaited implementation for nearly seven decades. This is natural, historical, and legal. Right for Palestinian people, statehood, and its declaration is also a sovereign right of all nations, as stipulated in international law. Additionally, Palestinians' right to self-determination has been repeatedly asserted by the UN. For decades, as you know, for decades, Israel has denied Palestinians their fundamental rights of freedom, equality, and self-determination through ethnic cleansing, colonization, racial discrimination, and military occupation. Despite abundant condemnation of Israeli politics by the UN, other international bodies and prominent human rights organizations, the world community has failed to hold Israel accountable and enforce a compliance with basic principle of law. Israeli crimes have continued with impunity.
Impunity.
Okay, impunity. You know, I speak English it's not like native language. I speak English in Arabic accent.
You'll be okay.
Okay, everything is under the
suit. Yeah.
Is it clear? Okay. In view of this continued failure, we cooperate with international progressive and democratic movements and parties that support the rights of Palestinian people. We struggle alongside other movements that seek to achieve liberation, peace, democracy, and socialism in order to preserve world peace and to protect the human rights and the environment. I would like to confirm the importance of the promotion of the common struggle against imperialism and its policies, which endanger a global peace to risk and which only serves the economic and military interests of the United States of America and its allies. And here we need the solidarity of the socialist and progressive forces in the world, with all people who are struggling in order to obtain their legitimate right to freedom, independence, and prosperity. We hope to coordinate our activities with you. Thank you very much for your inviting us, and I hope to listen from our comrades, and it is good to understand and to know about your activities in Australia. Thank you very much.
Yeah, I'd like to know more about the party which you're a member of, the Palestinian People's Party, and how it relates to the bigger political forces in Gaza and occupied Palestine more generally. So how does it relate to Hamas, and how does it relate to Fatah, and what level of support does it have in the Palestinian community?
بس نعرف عنه شو الحزب شو أهدافه شو يسوي شو علاقاته مع الحركات الأحزاب والحركات السياسية الأخرى في قطاع غزة والغربية وفتح وحماس
Okay, I can speak English, but I think it is better if you speak in Arabic in order to reach the idea exactly. أولا الحزب الشعب الفلسطيني هو امتداد للحركة الشيوعية في فلسطين.
The Palestine People's Party is really an extension of the communist movement in the land of Palestine. And it was established in 1919. After the Bolshevik Revolution in Russia,
1917. تربطنا علاقات جيدة مع جميع القوى والفصائل في فلسطين.
Palestine People's Party has an excellent relationship with all of the political movements and parties in Palestine.
نختلف معهم ونتفق في قضايا كثيرة ونختلف معهم أيضا.
We differ with them in many things and we agree with them also on many things.
نحن نضل هذا الحزب على مدار عقود من الزمن، على مدار تسع عقود من الزمن.
This party has been in existence for 9 decades.
نحن نؤمن بأهمية التضامن الدولي مع القضية الفلسطينية وأنه نحن مع توجه القيادة الفلسطينية ومنظمة التحرير إلى الأمم المتحدة لنيل الاعتراف بالدولة الفلسطينية.
We believe in the principle of gaining solidarity internationally, and we support the Palestinian leadership in spearheading towards getting recognition through the United Nations.
نحن أيضا نؤكد على أهمية توضيح الحقائق على الأرض لأن الاحتلال الإسرائيلي يحاول دائما أن يعطي صورة غير حقيقية على الواقع.
We also aim to clarify facts on the ground because the Zionist occupation authorities try to show a picture that does not relate to reality.
ونحن مع جماهيرية الانتفاضة على أن تكون جماهيرية وشعبية على أن يشارك جميع كافة العناصر أو شرائح المجتمع في هذه الانتفاضة ضد الاحتلال.
We are for the popularity basis of the intifada of the Palestinian uprising, and that all of the Palestinian people, including all of the political forces, must join in and participate in this intifada.
وذلك لسحب الذرائع التي تتحجج بها الحكومة الإسرائيلية وتحاول إظهار الفلسطيني بأنه إرهابي وهو صاحب حق.
The purpose of this is also to show that to take away all of the excuses that the Zionists use and to show that the Palestinian is not the terrorist and he's the owner of the right.
ونحن بالمناسبة ضد استهداف المدنيين من الجانبين.
And we are strongly against targeting civilians on either side.
So, لذلك احنا يعني كحزب دائما ندعو الى ضروره ان يكون نضالنا الجماهيري والشعبي واضحا في اتجاه الهدف الذي نسعى اليه.
Therefore we as a party we emphasize the fact that that our struggle should be popular based and on a mass basis to so that we could show the integrity of our cause.
ايضا نحن في حزب الشعب بذلنا جهودا كبيره من اجل اتمام المصالحه الفلسطينيه.
We've really spent a lot of effort on trying to complete the reconciliation between the Palestinian
reconciliation
to achieve
reconciliation
between the various political parties in Palestine.
كما تعلمون نحن كأحزاب يسارية وشيوعية في المنطقة لا يوجد دعم كافي ومادي لذلك ليست بالحجم الكبير وبالقوة الكبيرة.
As you know, the leftist political parties don't have strong support. Therefore, we have a limited support on the moral and material side for our work.
تعلمون أن القوى الأخرى لديها امتدادات إقليمية ودولية لتنفيذ أجندات خارجية.
And the other or an opposing forces have international extensions that they can gain support to implement their agendas on the ground.
لذلك نحن نعتمد على أنفسنا في دعم أنشطتنا وبرامجنا.
Therefore, we are very much self-reliant on implementing our programs and our agendas and our
ايضا رفاقنا النشطاء في جميع الحملات الوطنيه مثل حمله البي دي اس.
Our comrades are very much active and especially in campaigns such as the BDS.
اعتقد ان الاحتلال الاسرائيلي يشعر دائما بالاحراج وبالجبن عندما نواجهه بالحقائق.
We think that the Israeli Zionist occupation forces are very much feel embarrassed and they behave like cowards when we face them with the facts.
لأنه يحاول دائما خلط الأوراق ومحاولة تبرير الجرائم التي ترتكب بحق الشعب الفلسطيني بأنها دفاع عن النفس وهذه ليست حقيقة.
Because therefore they always try to mix the issue. Therefore they always try to mix the issues and to find all kinds of justifications to justify what they're doing and so as to make them throw the blame on us when that's not true.
هناك الكثير من الحديث ولكن باختصار حتى نسمع جميع الأسئلة.
And I have a lot to say, but I'll summarize it to this so we can hear more questions.
Thank you.
Anna Marie,
can you tell us a bit more about Hamas in Gaza?
يعني أولاً حركة حماس هي جزء من الشعب الفلسطيني.
First of all, Hamas is a part of the Palestinian people.
وهي حركة تقاوم الاحتلال.
And is a movement that resists the occupation.
ولكن نختلف معها أيديولوجياً وسياسياً وفكرياً.
We differ with them ideologically and politically and in their way of thinking.
نختلف معها في فكرياً ومحاولة أدلجة المجتمع الفلسطيني بالطريقة أدلجة يعني إنها بدها تحاول تفرض أفكارها على الناس.
We disagree with them not just their ideology but the fact that they try to impose their way of thinking on people.
كمان إنه حركة حماس نختلف معها في قضية الانقسام الفلسطيني.
And we hold Hamas partly responsible for the division
وأيضا حركة فتح تتحمل مسؤولية.
And Fatah too also is held responsible.
لأن كلا الحركتين يجب أن يحترما قرار الشعب الفلسطيني في الانتخابات.
Because both parties should respect the decisions of the Palestinian people when it comes to elections.
ونحن نختلف أيضا معها في طريقة النضال وفعاليته.
And we disagree with the, we also disagree with them by the way they conduct the struggle against the ethics of the struggle.
لأننا يجب أن نحمل برنامجا سياسيا مقبولا دوليا. كان نحن كحزب نؤمن بأن ضرورة أن نمتلك برنامجا سياسيا مقبولا دوليا لأن لا يمكن أن نغير العالم.
We also think that we have to have a political program that's internationally acceptable because we can't change the whole world.
ولكن حماس تحاول أن تفرض برنامجا يمكن أن يتعارض مع الرأي العام الدولي.
Well, and Hamas, but Hamas wants to impose a program that might disagree with the international consensus.
وهذا ممكن أن يضعف حركة التضامن الدولي مع قضيتنا الفلسطينية.
And this could weaken the international solidarity movement with the Palestinian people.
ولكن في نهاية المطاف نحن نأمل أن نصل في نهاية المطاف إلى توافق وطني ويكون هناك برنامج سياسي متفق عليه بين جميع القوى الوطنية يكون قادر على مخاطبة العالم ومقبولا أيضا لدى الجميع.
We hope that that in any case we all can reach some kind of national consensus, Palestinian national consensus that could be acceptable to all the Palestinians as well as acceptable to the world outside the Palestinian people.
Sam, I think next.
Thanks. I gather you also, your flights were delayed and you had no sleep and probably got jet lag, so thanks for that as well. Two interrelated questions. Yes. Do you see the struggle or the demand for a two-state solution as being a necessary or inevitable stepping stone to a so-called one-state solution? And secondly, some commentators argue that the process of Israeli settlements in the West Bank has gone so far that the demand for a two-state solution is now impossible, and that we can somehow, that is necessary to jump over the top of the argument for a two-state solution and argue for something, something different, a one-state solution. Can you explore that? And that's a big question, but...
Well, يقول يعني أنت بتحبذ الحل الدولتين ولا حل الدولة الواحدة يعني دولة للفلسطينيين واليهود والثانياً يقول يعني المستوطنات وغيرها البنية التحتية الإسرائيلية غلغة داخل برافق
الدولة الفلسطينية
بحيث إنه سوت الدولة الفلسطينية كانت تكون شبه مستحيل فشو رأيك
نحن يعني نؤمن بأن يكون هناك يعني حل دولة واحدة ولكن أحكي له إنه يعني إحنا يعني ممكن يعني بنأيد هذا الإشي ولكن إحنا نتكلم عن الواقع.
We would like to have one state solution, but we'd like to talk about reality.
ولكن إنه نحن نرى إنه حل الدولتين هو هذا البرنامج المقبول في كل العالم دولياً وهو الذي يمكن أن نصل إليه في الوقت الحالي.
But we think that what is internationally acceptable is a two-state solution, and it is the solution that we can practically reach at this stage in time.
وأيضاً محاولة فرض الأمر الواقع على حدود الدولة الفلسطينية هذا يمكن أن يتغير، ولكن هذا إذا كان هناك نية لدى المجتمع الدولي لإقامة الدولة الفلسطينية.
And the fact that there are those who are trying to impose the reality on the ground. This can change if there was earnest intentions by the international community.
ونحن نؤمن بأن في نهاية المطاف بعد هذا النضال أن شعبنا الفلسطيني سيحصل على أهدافه الوطنية المتمثلة بإقامة الدولة الفلسطينية مثل كل الشعوب فالشعوب كلها ناضلت وفي النهاية استطاعت أن تحصل على أهدافها الوطنية.
I think in the end that the Palestinians, after all the struggle, can achieve their state. Like all other nations, they struggled and they achieved what they sought to get.
على الرغم من المعاناة وعلى الرغم من التضحيات اللي قدمها شعبنا الفلسطيني ولكن نحن مؤمنين تماما بأن هذا الاحتلال حتما سيزول وسننال حقنا الفلسطيني حقنا الشعب.
You're saying that despite all the sacrifices and all this suffering that the Palestinians have faced, but in the end, the Palestinian people will get their state and they will get what they want in the end.
Any further questions? Next.
Slightly odd question, I suppose, but Gaza is a small part of Palestine that I knew when I was a little boy. We're talking about the loss of practically a whole country. But the point of my question is really, are we being a little bit fanciful in talking about UN decisions and international recognition? The United Nations is very largely controlled by organizations that people don't have any say in. International recognition is not the recognition of conscientious people throughout the world, but of governments like our own, I suppose. This is perhaps a negative point, but perhaps we are hoping too much from UN decisions and international recognition.
أفروض مؤخرا يعني استعملوا كثير بالمجتمع الدولي والقوات الدولية وهذا مضرب من الخيال إنه وبعدين غزة يقول أنا عرفته وأنا صغير كانت جزء صغير ولا تزال جزء صغير من
فلسطين
ويعني المتحدة متحكم فيها منظمات لا حولها ولا قوة والحكومات يعني مو تتخذ قرارات بدافع الإحساس بالضمير أو إشي يعني شو عندك يعني؟
يعني أشكره على سؤال يعني في غاية الأهمية وأشكره عليه.
I'd like to thank you very much for a very important question.
في الحقيقة هذه حقيقة ولا يمكن إغفالها.
This is what you said is true and you no one can deny that.
ولكن نحن نقول في نهاية المطاف يعني جميع الدول التي ناضلت كان هناك حل دولي.
But we believe, even so, we believe that all the nations, all the peoples who struggled, in the end, then there was an international solution.
ونعتقد بأنه في من الأهمية بمكان أن نكون ونحن نناضل أن يكون برنامجنا متفق مع الأسرة الدولية أو المجتمع الدولي.
And it's very important for us as we struggle that our aims, our objectives, are. Concurring with the international, the will of the international environment.
نعم أن موازين القوى ليست في صالح الفلسطينيين.
It's true that the balance of forces is not on the side of the Palestinians.
ونعلم كيف يقوم اللوبي الصهيوني في تغيير الحقائق والدفع في اتجاه أن نبتعد عن قضيتنا الفلسطينية. أن نبتعد عن هدفنا الوطني.
And we know that the Zionist lobbies work very hard to change the. The facts on everything, and they're always pushing us to get away from our main cause, the Palestine cause.
ولكن هذا يعطينا دافع دائما أن نعمل ونناضل أيضا من أجل أن نكون ضمن منظومة المجتمع الدولي ولا يمكن أن نناضل بعيدا عن ما هو متعارف عليه دوليا.
But this gives us an additional will to struggle more to achieve our objectives, which have to be within the, which have to concur within, have to be in agreement with the will of the international community, and cannot distance itself too far away from that, from these objectives.
ونأمل أيضا بعد الثورات العربية أن تتغير الظروف لصالح القضية الفلسطينية.
We also hope that after all these Arab revolutions, that things will change to the side of the Palestine cause.
Will I just say?
And we'll go to the chair, Anne-Marie. Everyone will get a turn, but I think Chris, then Bethia were next.
The last few years we've seen a huge groundswell across the Middle East of people's movements toppling governments and by huge, like millions of people coming into the streets. I'm just wondering, has there been sort of material or moral or political sort of acts of solidarity, the development of solidarity by brothers and sisters around the Middle East towards Palestine? And an example might be, say, the Tunisian swimmer in the Olympics who refused to compete in his heat because of the association with the member of the Israeli armed forces in that swimming contest. So I'm just wondering, for people in Palestine, for people in Gaza, has there been a direct sort of groundswell of that support for Palestine through that Arab Spring movement?
Sorry, I didn't understand the question. You think that the Arab Spring has influenced people inside Gaza?
Well, that also, but has there been an increase in solidarity activity?
In the Arab world?
In the Arab world, yeah.
من العالم العربي صار زيادة التضامن مع الشعب الفلسطيني بسبب هاي الثورات والثورات هاي أثرت على الجو العام السياسي داخل قطاع غزة.
بالتأكيد يعني هذه الثورات العربية بالمقام الأول قامت من أجل تغيير الواقع المزري في المجتمعات التي تعيشها.
Primarily the Arab revolutions really happened to change the ugly reality in the local environments that where they exist.
وهم ينظروا إلى الأنظمة التي كانت تحكمهم بأنها لا تعبر عن مصالحهم.
And of course, these people who made these revolutions, they were looking towards their regimes as regimes that don't represent their interests.
وطالما أن هذه الأنظمة لا تعبر عن مصالح جماهيرها، فكيف يمكن أن تعبر عن مصالح الشعب الفلسطيني؟
And if these regimes don't represent the interests of their people, how can they represent the interests of the Palestinians?
بالتأكيد.
For the Palestine cause.
لأنها نعتقد أن هي عقبة أمام التطور الشعوب العربية كانت.
Because these regimes, in any case, are an obstacle on the road towards the progress for the Arab peoples.
أيضا أن الاحتلال لا يستهدف فقط فلسطين ولكن يستهدف الوطن العربي الشرق الأوسط بأكمله لحماية المصالح الاستعمارية الغربية.
And of course, as you might know, the Zionist entity doesn't just target the Palestinian people and Palestine. It also targets the whole of the Arab world and the Middle East, and does that in service of the imperialism.
فالاحتلال يستحر يعني الحركة الصهيونية هي حركة رجعية متخلفة تستهدف كل ما هو حضاري وكل ما هو أصيل وكل ما هو وطني واشتراكي وتقدمي.
اصطلاحات كثيرة. Okay. This is I just got barraged with about 20 ideological exchanges. Of course, the Zionist entity targets everything that is
progressive
and civilized and is very much a retarded, backward, reactionary movement. I think that's about it.
وهي تستهدف كل الحركات الثورية في العالم.
And it targets also all of the revolutionary movements in the world.
لأننا نريد مجتمع خالي من الاستغلال والاحتلال والاستعمار ونريد مجتمعا اشتراكيا يقوم على العدالة الاجتماعية.
Because we want a society that is free from abuse and exploitation and based on equality and
مجتمع يعني اشتراكي خالي من الاستغلال.
We want to establish a socialist society that is free from exploitation.
وبالتالي هذا يتعارض مع أهداف الإمبريالية والصهيونية والاستعمار.
Of course, this collides with the will of the colonialism and imperialism.
وبالتالي نحن في حالة صراع طويل مع هذا المعسكر الأول الإمبريالي.
And therefore, we are in a long-term struggle with the imperialist camp.
Okay, yeah. This is good.
Bethia?
I'm not very familiar with the
with what?
Palestinian story, I guess. What would you idealize as a one-state solution?
Okay.
لا انا ما انا مو ما عندها معلومات كثير عن القضيه الفلسطينيه
sorry and also do you think that
يعني شو نظرتك بالنسبه للدوله الواحده في فلسطين
يعني من الواضح انه في حل بالفعل إقامة دولة فلسطينية هو يصب في مصلحة الفلسطينيين وهذا هو يعني مهم جدا.
The establishment of the Palestinian state is very much in the interest of the Palestinian people and this is very, something that's very important.
ولكن هل نستطيع بالفعل أن نحقق هذا الهدف؟
But is it real for us to try to establish this objective?
في ظل التوازن في ظل عدم وجود توازن في المجتمع الدولي لصالح القضية الفلسطينية.
You have to take into account that there is the balance of forces are not in favor of the Palestinians on the international level.
ولكن أن يكون هناك دولة فلسطينية للجميع بغض النظر عن دياناتهم هو شيء جميل.
To have a one state, one Palestinian state. Which would be under which all people from all backgrounds and religions living together is something that would be beautiful.
ولكن لا يمكن أن نستطيع في الوقت الحالي على الأقل تحقيقه.
In the time being, is something that something that we cannot achieve.
لأن هذا يعني هو نهاية الاحتلال ونهاية الدولة المشروع الصهيوني.
Because that would be the not only the end of the occupation, but it would be the end of the whole Zionist project.
ولذلك نحن نعلم حجم الدعم اللامحدود لهذا المشروع الصهيوني في الوقت الحالي.
And we have to take into account the limitless support that the Zionist project is getting all the time.
وبالتالي ستواجه فكرة الدولة الواحدة بقوة من الولايات المتحدة ومن أمريكا وكل الدول الاستعمارية.
For us to go along that path, we would face the barrage of resistance from the United States in supporting the Zionist state of Israel.
ونحن على الرغم من أننا نتمسك بما يرتضيه المجتمع الدولي إلا أننا لن نستطيع تحقيقه. In spite of we are
Arabic.
Okay. على الرغم من أننا نتمسك بقرارات الأمم المتحدة والبرنامج التي يرتضيه المجتمع الدولي وعلى الرغم من هيك إنه إحنا مش قادرين ننام.
And despite this, you know, even though we're only wanting to achieve the our objectives within the will of the international community, until now we haven't achieved this.
وبالتالي نحن نسعى لتحقيق في المرحلة الأولى هو البرنامج المتفق عليه دوليا.
And so, as a minimum, our main objective will be an objective which is agreed upon internationally.
هذا اللي بين أيدينا فقط الذي يمكن أن نواصل متفق عليه دوليا.
And this is really something that is within our grasp, something that we can achieve, something that is agreed upon internationally.
بالتأكيد إنه مشروع الدولة الواحدة هو ينال دعم كل المؤسسات والجمعيات بشكل يعني غير رسمي ولكن لا يوجد دعم رسمي لهذا المشروع.
For sure, all of the entities and societies and other grassroots organizations support the one-state solution. Support the one-state solution. Support the one-state solution, but this support really remains to be not an official support.
لذلك نحن نظل نظل من أجل تطبيق قرارات الشريعة الدولية على الأقل يعني.
And so, as a minimum, we support, or we our objective will be that which is agreed upon at the international level.
Would you just?
I think Bessie was just indicating wanted to just follow.
To what? The extent do you think that potentially being seen as having a one-state solution as a final goal would decrease the swiftness of achieving a two-state solution. Does that make sense?
إذا تركنا موضوع الدولتين وحاولنا نروح على الدولة الواحدة، هل هذا يأثر بشكل سلبي على حل الدولتين؟
يعني إذا
صعب شوي،
يعني إذا إحنا روحنا على الدولتين هذا مش هنقدر نصل للدولة الواحدة.
لا إذا أنت تركت الدولتين على الدولة الواحدة يعني حتأثر على موضوع حل الدولتين بشكل سلبي.
يعني إحنا بالأخير إحنا يعني في النهاية بدنا دولة فلسطينية كباقي كل دول العالم، بدنا إحنا نكون إلنا دولة فلسطينية معترف فيها دوليا، بده يكون في دولة بالأخير، يعني هذا هو هدفنا.
In the end really our initial objective whatever it is has to be that we have to achieve a Palestinian state.
We need to state نحن بحاجة إلى دولة ويكون إلى حدود وعاصمتها القدس وعودة اللاجئين تبقى القرارات الشرعية.
So our main objective remains to be establishing that Palestinian state, and the capital has to be Jerusalem, and the refugees must be able to have the be offered the choice of going back.
يعني بتلاحظوا قديش الحكومة الاحتلال الإسرائيلي بتحاول بكل قوة منع أن يكون لنا دولة فلسطينية لأن هي مرتاحة، لأنه طالما فيش دولة هي مرتاحة.
And so you see the Zionists are really striving to prevent us from having that state because as long as we don't have a state they're relaxing, you know, they're not worrying about anything.
الإسرائيلية في كافة المؤسسات الدولية وفي جرائم الحرب، ولأننا سنكون دولة وسيكون واضحا أن الاحتلال يشن عدوانا على دولة أخرى.
Because when we have a state, we will be able to chase after them on the international level, and we will try to go for issues such as war crimes and other violations that have made against us, and that they're doing against us. So like it'd be a struggle between two states rather than between. An occupying state and an occupied people.
So, يعني إحنا بالنهاية هدفنا الرئيسي إزالة هذا الاحتلال من أجل أن يستطيع الفلسطيني يمارس حياته الطبيعية وأي يقرر مصيره. يكون لديه تقرير مصير.
We need that state so that the Palestinian person can live their normal lives and they can decide their future. And self-determination.
I think Antoinette is next.
Yeah, I just say briefly, I remember the chicken farmer in the Gaza Strip that had the chickens and they were bombed and they were just rotting there, like, you know. And also the security, the Hamas security, were lying on the ground bleeding and they didn't even know if there was a war. They just attacked. So to talk about the two-state solution, how can you forgive that? Yes. And your cause is our cause. You believe that. I'm Greek by birth. I believe in democracy and the rights. And what is the International Court of Justice doing? We're going to take these terrible people to the International Court of Justice. I think we've got the wrong ones. I'm really happy to meet you.
Thank you for
فهمت عليها؟
يعني فهمت بس بدي اتاكد منها.
اوكي قول انه بتذكر انه شفت صور قطع غزه الدجاجات اللي كانت بتعفن وكيف جماعه الشرطه او جماعه الامن حماس مضروبين وبينزفوا وما بيعرفوا انه في حرب اصلا. قول انا بدكم تاخذوهم للمحاكم الدوليه، اي محاكم هاي لهذول الجرائم ما بتخلص. وانا يونانيه بالولاده وانا بس بدي تتحقق العداله.
شكراً لسؤالها.
We'd like to thank you for the question.
بالحقيقة إنه التاريخ يتحدث أن يتحدث لنا ويجيب على هذا السؤال أن معظم الأنظمة الدكتاتورية في النهاية خضعت للمحاكمة في نهاية المطاف.
History says that all despotist and all criminal regimes have had to subdue themselves to justice in the end.
God tells me that.
ومن الواضح انه معظم الانظمه الدكتاتوريه والانظمه القمعيه اخذت عقابها سواء كان من خلال محاكم دوليه او من خلال شعوب.
And all of the dictatorial regimes have had their punishment, have had their payback through international courts or through their own people.
ونحن
go through the chair internet is better.
ونحن نأمل ومقتنعين تماما أن هذه الجرائم لن تمر دون عقاب.
We really sincerely hope that these crimes will not pass unpunished.
وكما رأيتم الكثير من الأنظمة الدكتاتورية سواء في العالم العربي أو في العالم كله في نهاية خضعت لمحاكمة الشعوب.
And I think you've all witnessed that the dictatorial regimes in the Middle East or outside the Middle East have in the end been subdued to being tried by their people.
Yeah, they rock from the inside.
Antoinette,
we just let. Can you say that?
Antoinette, please just let.
He's the star of the show.
وإذا كانت بالفعل في اللحظات التي نعيشها أن لا يوجد عدالة مطلقة، نحن نريد العدالة النسبية.
And if our world we can't get absolute justice, we will settle for relative justice.
ونحن نرى أيضا أن المستقبل للشعوب، المستقبل للعدالة الاجتماعية، المستقبل للحركات التحرر وليس للأنظمة الدكتاتورية.
And we think that the future is for the people and not for the dictatorial regimes.
وكل تاريخ حركات التحرر شاهد على ذلك.
And the history of the liberation movements is a witness to this.
نحن نرى ماذا حدث في جنوب أفريقيا، كيف استطاعت الحركات التحرر أن تنال أهدافها الوطنية.
We saw the liberation movements in South Africa and how they managed to achieve their national objectives.
ونرى أيضا كيف حققت الثورة الهندية أهدافها أيضا.
We saw how the Indian Revolution achieved its objectives.
والكثير والأمثلة كثيرة ومتعددة.
And there are endless examples, various examples.
وفي نهاية الأنظمة الاستعمارية هي ستفحر قبرها بيدها.
And in the end, the colonialist regimes will dig their own graves.
وهذا ما أكده ماركس.
And this is what was emphasized by Marx.
وبالتالي لا داعي أن نتشائم، فالنضال طويل ويأخذ مراحل متعددة.
And so we don't need to be pessimistic. The struggle is very long and it could take various stages.
أوقات في أوقات كثيرة لا تكون الأمور لصالح حركات التحرر، وفي أوقات تكون لصالحها.
And there are some stages in that things can be on the side of the national liberation movements, and on other times they could be against the liberation movements.
من يتوقع أن تقوم الثورة في تونس وفي مصر؟
Who would have expected there would be revolutions in Tunisia and Egypt?
الناس لا كانت الناس لا تستطيع أن تتكلم.
People there could not even speak.
وعانت من التعذيب والاعتقال والسجون.
And suffered all kinds of persecution, jail.
ولكن عندما جاءت لحظة التغيير.
But when the moment of change came.
There is لن يكون هناك قوة يمكن أن تقف في اتجاه إرادة الشعوب.
There was no nothing that could stand in the way of the will of the people.
وبالتالي أعتقد أننا نحن في مرحلة سنكون في مرحلة تحول من مرحلة الاستعمارية والإمبريالية والرأسمالية لمرحلة الاشتراكية والعدالة الاجتماعية.
Therefore, the we'll pass through a moment in time we'll be in the phase of change from imperialism and imperialism and capitalism to socialism and social justice.
نحن نؤمن بذلك وسنناضل من أجل ذلك.
We believe in this and we'll struggle for this.
There were a number of hands who've gone up, and Ivan, so I just want to get an idea of who's still interested in asking a question or making a comment who hasn't yet spoken. I think there's four people indicating. Well, I think what we'll do is we'll take those four people, and then that might probably bring the meeting to a conclusion. I think we'll go Kamala next, and then Lefty.
Just a question about what life is like in Gaza today. How has it changed since Operation Pass left? And just living, healthcare, education, jobs. What's the electricity? What's it like for people to be living in Gaza?
Social
today?
Situation.
Yeah.
You want to talk about social situation? Yeah. You speak slowly, very good. I understand everyone. Thank you.
You don't need me now.
يعني هي بدها الوضع الاجتماعي
وبعض الناس وبالذات بعد عملية الرصاص المصبوغ.
هي فهمت بعد عملية الرصاص المصبوغ. يعني بالتأكيد إنه بعد الحرب على العدوان على قطاع غزة بالتأكيد تأثرت الحياة الاجتماعية وكافة نواحي الحياة.
After the offensive or aggression against Gaza, for sure things changed very much in Gaza.
تعلمين أن الأراضي الزراعية تم تجريفها وتدميرها.
As you might know, the agricultural land has been dug up and destroyed by the Israelis.
لذلك نرى أن شريحة المزارعين فقدت أعمالها.
Therefore, the farmers have virtually all lost their jobs.
فقدوا مزارعهم.
They've lost their farms.
أيضا عندما نأتي أن نتحدث عن العمال أيضا فقدوا وظائفهم.
The majority of the workers have lost their jobs as well.
لأن المصانع تم تدميرها بالكامل.
Because the factories have been destroyed totally.
الناس بعد الحرب كانت تفكر فقط كيف تلملم جراح عائشة.
People after the war really were just حرب. And the children too are very much traumatized because of that war.
لا يمكن أن تتخيلوا حجم الدمار وحجم وقوة الضرب التي كانت تقوم به الحكومة أو الاحتلال الإسرائيلي.
That you can never imagine the devastation of the war, of the aggression of the Israelis, how strongly they hit Gaza at the time.
يعني تكون يعني على سبيل المثال أثناء الحرب تكون أنت نايم فبتسمع الانفجار ما بتحس حالك إلا قاعد بتجري في نص الليل من كثر حجم الرعب والصوت وقوته العمارات تتهزهز.
For example, you're just sleeping at night in Gaza during that war, and that suddenly you find an explosion, and the next thing you know, you're running out in the street. You know, you're out of your bed and you're running out in the street like crazy.
المباني تتحرك نتيجة الضرب كالزلزال.
And the buildings are moving left and right like there's an earthquake.
وهذه المباني الغير مستهدفة تكون.
And we're talking here about the buildings that are not targeted.
ما بالكم أن تكون المباني المستهدفة كيف بتكون الوضع؟
How can you imagine how the targeted buildings would be like?
الوضع كان في غاية الخطورة وفي غاية الصعوبة وفي في عز يعني ال عز المطر يعني كان الجو
and the situation was incredibly difficult and incredibly challenging, especially when you can imagine it was winter and it was raining as well.
ففي هذا الوقت ترى الناس يفتقدون منازلهم وملاذهم وتخرج في الشوارع مع أطفالهم والجو في غاية البرودة والرعب والخوف.
So you have whole families like losing their houses and going out living in the street with their children, and they're feeling wet and cold and scared and etc.
يعني على سبيل المثال كانوا كان الجيش الاحتلال يتصل على البيوت ويقول لهم أخذوا البيوت سنقوم بالقصف.
And the next thing, another example is when the Israelis they call out to people, leave your houses, we're going to bomb that area, for example.
على سبيل المثال نحن نسكن في مبنى مكون من عدة شقق.
He says, I live in a building that has several units, several flats.
زي كل اتصلوا يعني علي بقول لك جيش الاحتلال يتحدث عليكم إخلاء المبنى.
They called him. He's saying they called me and they say we are the Israeli army, we're the army of occupation. We'd like to ask you to leave that building.
لأننا سوف نقوم بقصف البناية.
Because we're going to bomb that building.
وعندما يعني تحدثت مع إخوتي فقلنا لن نغادر البيت أين سنذهب؟
Then
في منتصف الليل يعني وين بدنا نروح؟
So I spoke with my brothers. We all agreed we're going to stay in the building. We're going to go in the middle of the night.
الخطر والرعب في كل مكان.
There's fear everywhere. Anyway.
لذلك قررنا أن نظل في البيت مهما حصل.
Therefore, we decided to stay in the house, whatever happens.
وكنا نتوقع أن يتم قصفه وننتظر هذه اللحظة.
And we were waiting to be bombed. We were waiting for that moment.
ولم نبلغ يعني الوالد والوالدة والإخوان حتى لا يرتعبوا.
And we didn't tell the rest of our parents and the rest of the family in order not to scare them.
وبالتالي انتظرنا حتى الصباح وجاءت العدالة السماء ولم يقصفوا البيت.
And then we waited until the morning and then justice came from high above and we were not bombed.
ولذلك الناس لما كانت تسيب بيوتها تروح تقعد في المدارس عشر عائلات بعض في غرفة صغيرة.
And we had like families leaving their houses and going to schools and like you have sometimes 10 families in each classroom.
وعلى الرغم منها راحت على مدارس الأمم المتحدة إلا أن المدارس قصفت وقتل فيها الكثير من الأبرياء والمدنيين.
Even those who in some cases instances people who went to the United Nations schools they got bombed and anyway and lots of civilians were killed.
فلم يكن هناك أي ملاذا آمنا.
So there was no safe sanctuary anyway.
إسرائيل كانت تستخدم كل الأسلحة المحرمة دوليا لدرجة أنها استخدم القنابل الفوسفورية.
And Israel used all of the banned weapons to the extent that they used the phosphoric bombs.
لدرجة أن هذه القنابل لا تنطفئ، عندما تنطفئ يأتي الأطفال يلعبون بها فتشتعل مرة أخرى.
And these bombs never settle down. And sometimes they look as though they've become benign, and the children come and play with them, and then they set off again.
لا نعلم ما هي حجم المخاطر في المستقبل على الأطفال والنساء و. والمدنيين بشكل عام.
We do not know what the future dangers that lie because of these weapons for children, women, and civilians in general.
وبالتالي إنه أعتقد إنه الحرب كانت يعني قاسية جدا ومدمرة واستخدموا كل ما يستطيعون وكانهم يحاربون جيشا آخر وبالتالي ولكن الحقيقة أنهم لا يحاربوا جيشا آخر حاربوا هم المدنيين فقط.
Therefore the war was really hard and really tough on us and the Israelis fought as though they were fighting another army but in fact they were not fighting another army they were fighting people.
يعني الناس الصبح تصحى تشوف هذا المنظر بقعد الصبح يدوروا على حاجاتهم يدوروا على أطفالهم. هذا بيكون منظر في الليل القصف وفي الصبح بيبدو الناس يدوروا على يعني أغراضهم وأبنائهم وأطفالهم.
Then go to sleep in the at night, wake up in the morning, see something like this in this picture, and then people would wake up in that morning and go out and look for their things and for their children.
نحن نعتقد أن هذه الحقائق يجب أن تصل إلى العالم بطريقة صحيحة وليس بطريقة الإعلام المزيفة.
So we really emphasize the need to have these facts reaching people as they are through the media and not through distorted as they are at the moment.
وهذا يعني الحديث اللي أتكلم فيه جزء بسيط من المآسي والويلات التي شهدها أبناء قطاع غزة.
And this is just really a small sample of the great suffering that is that the people of Gaza have seen.
لأن هناك عائلات بالكامل تم قتلها وأبادتها.
Because whole families have been exterminated, just being killed.
بأطفالها وشيوخها ونسائها.
Including the children and old people, women, the lot.
وهذه نتائج الحرب لم تنتهي. فكم من امرأة أرملة الآن؟
And the results of these wars are ongoing. Can you imagine how many widow women there are?
قديش كمان في أطفال يتامى؟
How many orphan children there are?
قديش أمهات فقدت أعز أبنائها؟
How many mothers lost their children?
فقدوا بيوتها أعز ما يملكون.
Many families lost their homes.
وبالتالي أعتقد أننا أن هذه على الرغم من كل هذه الويلات إلا أن شعبنا الفلسطيني صامد.
Despite all this suffering, the Palestinian people are steadfasting.
ولن يثنيه ذلك عن مواصلة نضاله.
And the Palestinian people will not be allayed or be pushed aside from carrying on their struggle.
وبالفعل إنه يعني على الرغم من الحرب الإبادة اللي تعرض لها شعبنا الفلسطيني إلا إنه هو يمتلك الإرادة والعزيمة.
And despite this war of extermination against the Palestinian people, the Palestinian people have still the will and the stamina to carry on.
وهو يعني طالما إنه يوجد أصدقاء له في جميع العالم مثلكم فهو يعطيه الدفعا ومعنوي ويرفع من معنوياته.
And as long as we have, as long as Palestinian people have friends like you all over the world, then this is really helps to. It's a good push for the Palestinian people and really raises our morale.
When the Palestinian statehood is achieved,
yes.
Will Israelis be invited in the settlements? Will they be invited to be Palestinian citizens, or will they be exiled? Or
yes.
What might happen?
بصير المواطنين الفلسطينيين ولا نطلعهم برا
يعني بالتأكيد إنه عملية المفاوضات أو عملية السلام فشلت لأن الاحتلال لا يريد أن يوقف الاستيطان.
The process, the peace process, the so-called peace process of negotiating has failed because the occupation refuses to stop the settlements colonization.
وبالتالي لا يمكن أن تتحقق الدولة في ظل وجود هذه المستوطنات.
And therefore, no one can establish a state in the shadow of these settlements.
يعني إنه من شروط أن يكون هناك دولة فلسطينية أن تكون كاملة السيادة ولا يوجد أي إسرائيلي يعيش في هذه الدولة.
One of the conditions of having the solution is that there should be a Palestinian state that is fully sovereign, and there would not be any Israelis living like this in the occupied territories.
وبالتالي الدولة الفلسطينية يجب أن تكون فلسطينية بكل ما تحمل الكلمة من معنى.
And the Palestinian state has to be Palestinian in every word, by any definition.
Thank you.
I think we'll take Vince and then Rob, and then we'll bring the meeting to a formal part of a close. So Vince next.
This may be a difficult question.
Shoot. I like difficult questions.
Shoot.
Because we need to reach to the suggestions or some of points we can work together after this workshop or forum.
Okay.
You told us about many terrible things like bombings, demolitions, targeted assassinations. In addition to that, there are these detentions without charges or trial. And in the background, of course, is the perpetrator, the Zionists, and they are a huge, monstrous machine. Now, we here, I'm speaking personally, I have not lived that life. I have not seen dying people around me. I've not seen buildings falling down around me. I haven't suffered. Now, you said that the Palestinian people will not give up, and they have the will and the stamina to carry on. Now, my question is, what is it they've got that keeps them going? What is that thing? Because that's miraculous. To survive when you're tested to the extreme degree, and the people still keep going on. Mm-hmm. What do they have?
Speaking on the Palestinian, the إصابة وتحمل وعنده طاقة لا محدودة يقول منين لهم هاي الطاقة الرهيبة اللي تخليهم يصمدوا ويتحملوا وإيش كره المكت هذا
ليش؟ إيه؟
كله عندي مكت يعني الغلبة هاي اللي بتغلبين منين اللي يصبر ويتحمل؟ يعني شيء معجزاتي هذا شيء معجزة منين لهم هاي الشيء هذا؟
أوكي. Thank you for your question. Very good. من واضح إنه الشعب الفلسطيني اعتاد على الوضع الصعب.
The Palestinian people have gotten used to this difficult situation.
فنحن علينا من الاستعمار على مدار عقود طويلة من الزمن حتى قبل الاحتلال الإسرائيلي.
We are in continued struggle even before the Israeli occupation.
والمجتمع الشعب الفلسطيني يؤمن بأن هذا النضال هو استحقاق وحق لكل الفلسطينيين.
And we believe that this is a struggle, is a right, and is entitlement for all the Palestinians.
عندما نرى الأم الفلسطينية عندما يستشهد ابنها فهي في الكثير من الأحيان والكثير من الأمهات هي تقول أن هذا ثمن النضال وتقبل في الأمر الواقع على الرغم من المأساة وحجم
the average Palestinian mother in occupied territories has reached a stage where if a child dies or son dies, she accepts this and says this is simply the bill that we have to pay in our struggle.
لأننا نعتبر النضال هو شرف.
Because we think that struggling is an honor.
وهو أيضا يعني واجب ديني أيضا.
It's also a religious duty.
الكثير من الأمهات كانت تودع أبنائها قبل أن تذهب لكي تناضل.
Many of the mothers used to say goodbye to their children when they set out to on their struggle.
المرأة الفلسطينية هي تعلم أنها عندما تبعث أو ترسل أبنائها من أجل النضال فهي بالتالي تحمي مستقبل الأبناء الشعب الفلسطيني in general بشكل عام.
The mothers when they say goodbye to their children when they go out to struggle they know they're doing so they are protecting the generations that come out after that of the Palestinian people.
والكثير من الأمهات بالفعل ودعت أبنائهم بالزغاريت.
And many mothers have said goodbye to their children by cheering them.
أنت عندما تأتي إلى غزة ترى أن هناك عائلة تكون فاقدة أكثر من ابن لها وأكثر من فرد لها.
And you'll find sometimes that there are families who have lost more than one child, more than one member of that family.
في الكثير من الأسر تجد أن هناك الكثير من الصور لأبنائهم الشهداء الذين ضحوا من أجل
When you go in their houses, you'll find pictures of their martyrs on their walls, their own family members, martyrs on their walls. You'll find more than one picture sometimes on that wall.
وبالتالي حتى أن الطبيعة الغريزة تحتم على كل فرد أن يدافع عن وطنه في الغريزة موجودة.
And this has become almost an instinct. You know, we have an instinct that we have to defend our motherland.
ترون أن النحلة عندما تدافع عن النحلة عندما تدافع عن بيتها فهي تموت بعد أن تقوم بالدفاع عنه.
The bee, when it tries to defend its hive, it dies after it does does the act of defending its hive.
Yeah, يعني التضحية من أجل الحياة.
It's sacrificing a life to save lives.
لأن الشعب الفلسطيني يحب الحياة وبالتالي هو يضحي من أجلها.
And because the Palestinian people love life and therefore they sacrifice themselves for that.
بالتالي التضحية تأتي من أجل سعادة الشعب الفلسطيني ومن أجل مستقبله ومستقبل أبنائه.
And that sacrifice also comes to guarantee the future and the happiness of the Palestinian people and the future of the children and the children's children.
وبالتالي عندما تزوروا إن شاء الله قطاع غزة سوف ترون معظم العائلات ضحت وقدمت تضحيات وتتكلم عن هذه التضحيات بالفخر والاعتزاز.
Therefore, if you ever visit Gaza, you'll find that the majority of families have made sacrifices and they'll speak with very proudly about these sacrifices.
ولكن بالتأكيد أن هذا جرح ونزيف مفتوح وحزن كبير.
But at the same time, you can be rest assured that it's a this is a suffering and a wound and an open wound and it's really suffering for these people.
بالتالي الفلسطينيين يمكن أن يختاروا الموت على ألا يخضعوا للمذلة.
But in any case, the Palestinians would rather die than subdue themselves to humiliation.
لأننا نريد تقرير المصير.
Because we want self-determination.
صراحة يعني صراحة إنه المآسي كثيرة جدا جدا جدا.
And our and the devastation and are many and incredible.
هل يمكن أن تتخيلوا أن يقوم أسيرا فلسطينيا بالإضراب عن الطعام لمدة 90 يوما؟
Can you imagine a Palestinian prisoner going on hunger strike for about 90 days?
لمدة 3 شهور بدون أكل؟
3 months without food.
وقارب على أن يموت.
And is on the verge of death.
ولكن في النهاية استطاع أن يحقق هدفه في الحرية.
But in the end, he got his objective of gaining freedom.
نفس الاحتلال الإسرائيلي يستغرب القوة والعزيمة التي يتمتع بها شعبنا الفلسطيني.
The Israeli occupation itself is very much wondering where this stamina and all this drive is coming from.
وبالتالي عندما يعلن أسرانا الإضراب عن الطعام ترى أن هناك حالة من الطوارئ عند الاحتلال الإسرائيلي.
Therefore, when our prisoners, Palestinian prisoners, when they go on hunger strike, you'll find the Zionists are in a state of emergency.
لقد حاصروا الشعب الفلسطيني ولكن خرج من تحت الأرض من أجل أن يبحث عن الحياة ومقومات الحياة عبر الحدود.
They've managed to besiege the Palestinian people and strangle them, but the Palestinian people come up from under the ground and conquer the borders.
وعندما عجز الفلسطينيين عن استرجاع أسرهم قاموا بخطف الجنود الإسرائيليين.
When the Palestinians failed to get their prisoners back, they managed to kidnap an Israeli soldier.
لقد فكر الاحتلال بجميع المؤامرات أن يكيد على الشعب الفلسطيني ولكنها فشلت على صخرة صمود شعبه.
The Zionists have concocted all kinds of conspiracies against the Palestinians, but these conspiracies have been smashed on the face of the Palestinian rock.
ونحن بالمناسبة لا نواجه احتلال إسرائيل فقط. ونواجه أنظمة رجعية.
we don't just suffer from the Zionist occupation. We suffer also from reactionary regimes.
على الرغم أيضا أننا نعيش بلا كهرباء كافية. معظم الأوقات الكهرباء قاطعة عنا.
Most of the time we don't have electricity. Most of the time the power has failed.
وعلى الرغم إنه المية ملوثة.
And our water is not potable at all.
ولا يوجد إيش اسمه هذا الفيول.
النفط.
نفش اللي هو سولار.
We don't have fuel. We don't have diesel.
على الرغم من إنه الناس كمان فقر شديد.
And there is a abject poverty in Gaza at the moment.
إلا إنه يعني الناس قادرة إنها تعيش وتتكيف مع هالوضع الصعب.
But people still acclimatize themselves and they manage to live in this difficult situation. If I may just add to Brother Shamikh, I'm a Palestinian from diaspora and he's from Palestine. Palestine. Mm-hmm. We got the first strike in our faces in 1948. Mm-hmm. And so because they saw how much we got humiliated outside Palestine,
yes.
they learned that they'd rather die than leave Palestine.
Mm-hmm.